Let us study the force on a dielectric slab during insertion in a capacitor. You can see in this picture there is a capacitor which is connected to a battery of a potential difference V and a dielectric slab which can completely fill the space between the capacitor is being inserted into it. Right now it is inserted up to a distance x. We are also given that the plate separation is dN, plate area is LB, where L is the length of the plate and B is the width of the plates. Now in this situation, when the dielectric, say its dielectric constant is K and it fills up to a distance x, in this situation we can consider the capacitor to be composed of two capacitors in parallel. One is this air capacitor and other is this dielectric capacitor. And we can see that the plates are common for both. So these two can be considered in parallel combination, like in previous section we have discussed about insertion of plates, insertion of dielectric slab between the plates perpendicular to the plates. So in this situation, we can write when dielectric is inserted up to a distance x, the capacitance is, here the capacitance we can write as C1 plus C2, where C1 is the capacitance of air capacitor and C2 is the capacitance of the region in which the dielectric is already inserted. So in this situation, this C1 we can write as epsilon naught A by D. The length of the plate for the air capacitor we can write as L minus x. So its capacitance will be epsilon naught, the area will be L minus x multiplied by B divided by D, plus the capacitor C2 is having a plate area which we can write as XB, and its dielectric constant is K, so its capacitance can be written as K epsilon naught XB by D. Now in this situation, if we calculate the total energy stored in the capacitor, we can directly write energy stored in capacitor is, that is the total energy stored between the, in the region between the plates. This can be written as half CV square. Here we use half CV square because V is always constantly maintained by the battery. So this can be written as half. If we just substitute this capacitance, we can keep this epsilon naught B by D common. So this will be epsilon naught BV square by D multiplied by, we can write it L minus X plus KX. Here we can see that energy depends on the position of dielectric slab as it is inserted. The overall potential energy is changing. And here we can see if this plate is positively charged, is negatively charged, there will be some bound charges appear on the dielectric slab which are opposite to the plates, and due to opposite charges the plate will experience an inward force into the region between the plates of capacitor, due to which the slab will have a tendency to move automatically inside. If we wish to find out the force on dielectric slab, this force on dielectric slab can be directly given by the magnitude of du by dx, which we know that the rate of variation of potential energy with the position, that is potential energy gradient, we can call it the amount of force exerted on the particle or the slab in this situation. If we differentiate it, you can see the result we are getting is epsilon naught BV square by 2D, and differentiation of L becomes 0 and X becomes, so this minus 1 plus K, so it can be written as K minus 1. So this is the expression for the force, and you can see it is a constant force which is acting on the dielectric slab when it is inserted between the plates of a capacitor across a battery of potential difference V. It does not change with the amount of a slab which is already inserted into the plates. So, if the plates are considered smooth, then on slightly inserting the slab, even if we release it, it will enter with a constant acceleration because the force applied onto it is a constant.